लॉजिकल मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू विधिज्ञा प्रेजेंट्स द हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर एनालिसिस। इन टुडेज सेशन देयर विल बी फॉलोइंग सेगमेंट्स। फर्स्ट, ओवरव्यू ऑफ टुडेज न्यूज़पेपर। सेकंड, मस्ट नो टॉपिक्स एंड एक्सप्लेनेशन। एंड थर्ड, क्विज टाइम विद फाइव इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस। सो स्टार्टिंग विद द फर्स्ट सेगमेंट, नाउ हियर द फर्स्ट आर्टिकल दैट वी सी इज हाल्ट हॉस्टिलिटीज फॉर इवैकुएशन, इंडिया अर्जेस रशिया एंड यूक्रेन। सो द इंडिया हैज अपील टू रशिया दैट फॉर सर्टेन टाइम पीरियड दैट Russia must halt its hostile process so that it can evacuate its citizen. So there's nothing much in this article. It's just a basic information that this is what is happening, and you know most of the information related to Russia and Ukraine that can come in the CLAT examination. India abstains again in UN vote. So India again abstained to vote in UN. So this we will discuss in this time Human Rights Council, that is United Nations Human Rights Council, which were condemning the Russia's invasion and which has led to the fatalities or loss of civilian lives. So this is another article. So in this article, there is nothing much to read. Now the third important article is Ruckus in Haryana Assembly as government tables anti-conversion bill. So this topic we'll discuss in detail about anti-conversion bill. However, this is not important about anti-conversion bill. What is important is Article 25 of Constitution of India, that we will discuss. On this topic, Karnataka announces no tax hike in budget. However, that is not important. What is important here is Mekedatu project. Mekedatu project. So we will discuss that. What is Mekedatu project? Now, Russia's war, the impracticality of the violence. So the topic is not, this article is not relevant. It shows that like how the countries earlier like it discussed about World War I, World War II, the about hostilities and the violent path that it has taken, and then it also talks about that Mahatma Gandhi's leadership and his path of non-violence, how that is important, how that is important for the present world. So there is like most of an ideological argument that, however, nothing from this article can come in your examination. So that is not important. This article is not important in for your exam. Then again, this topic is related to COVID-19 vaccine. This topic talks about that now in second wave, there was high number of fatalities and high number of cases. However, in third wave, that has reduced. And the reason because it that India has achieved a good number of vaccination. And that is the reason that we are witnessing low cases. So not much important in this article also. Talks about various vaccines, for example, biological e-vaccine, then Genova, then vaccine by Zydus Cadila, and then other vaccines by Serum Institute and Sputnik by Russia. So these are, and Corbivax is there, then Covaxin by Bharat Biotech, and this is related to UP election. So again, not important for your exam. Now another topic is Andhra Pradesh High Court judgment on Amravati. So when Telangana was created in 2014, then the capital of Andhra Pradesh was decided to be Amaravati, and Telangana, that is of Telangana, Hyderabad. So later the government passed a bill for decentralized development, and in which it planned three capitals. So now this topic is important. So this we will discuss in detail in our explained session, in our second segment. This is not important. Now again, this open helplines for kin of Indian national again is like evacuation of Indian citizens from Ukraine. Same article. India abstains from vote to prove actions for Russia. Here the topic important is International Atomic Energy Agency. So that we will discuss. What is Operation Ganga? So Operation Ganga, you have to remember that Operation Ganga is an operation by government of India to bring back, or you can say to evacuate Indian citizens stuck in Ukraine. So this is important. This is factual information that you have to remember. Then another important article is Russia seizes Europe's largest nuclear plant. So this we'll discuss what this plant is, however, and Putin says Ukraine must meet. And then what are the Russian demand against President, against Putin? What are the demands raised by Russia against Ukraine? So that we'll discuss. And UNSC hold meets to discuss Zaporizhia fire. So this is the Europe's largest nuclear power plant captured by Russia. So UN will hold a meeting, United Nations Security Council will hold a meeting to discuss about this. Close to revival of Iran nuclear deal. So we have discussed about Vienna talks, which they are discussing about Iran's nuclear deal. So again, earlier we have discussed about joint comprehensive plan of action. There was like P5 countries, then Iran was there, then either Germany was there. However, into the objective of this JCPO that USA will not impose sanction and Iran will use the nuclear technology only for civilian purposes. However, later in 2018, USA backed out from JCPO deal and claiming that Iran is not following the deal. The Iran is not following the commitments that they are a deal, and Iran is enriching its nuclear so that it can make nuclear weapons. That is why. And then later, Iran and USA imposed sanctions on Russia. USA imposed sanction on Iran. Now again, there is a talk going between Iran and P5 and Germany that this sanction should be removed, that USA will remove the sanction from Iran and Iran will not enrich its nuclear uranium to make nuclear weapon. However, it will only use nuclear material for civilian purposes, that is for developing nuclear energy. So Shane Warne, cricket's transcendent king of spin, passes away. Shane Warne, age 52, passed away due to suspected heart attack. So you have to remember about Shane Warne. So that is all today's article. These are the important articles. Now we'll discuss. So the first topic is Haryana anti-conversion bill, and second, Meghdatu project. Third, capital building. Fourth, India abstain from vote to probe actions of Russia. Fifth, Russia seizes Europe's largest nuclear power plant. These are the topics that we'll discuss. So starting with the first, ruckus in Haryana assembly as government tables anti-conversion bill. So what this bill says, any religious priest or any person intending to organize a conversion shall give prior notice to district magistrate about the venue. So if such a conversion is happening, a prior notice to be given to district magistrate about the venue where such event is happening. However, these provisions are not important for your exam. However, but for the time being, we'll just discuss this provision so that you get to know what are the provisions. A copy of this notice shall be passed on notice board outside the. So a copy of this notice shall be put on a notice board outside district magistrate, and if anyone has any objection, they can file the objection within 30 days. And when the objection has been filed, then DM will investigate the matter. DM will investigate and decide whether the conversion is intended to be a contravention of Section 3. So then district magistrate will investigate and will see whether it is in contravention of Section 3 of anti-conversion bill or not. And if the district magistrate comes to the conclusion that the intended conversion is contravention of Section 3, then he shall decline the intended conversion. So it will see whether it is a violation of Section 3 or not. If yes, then it will prevent the conversion, and because it is in contravention of Section 3. So that is important. Now what is important is Article 25. So Article 25 says freedom, Article 25 of Constitution of India. So it says freedom of conscience and free profess, practice and propagation of religion. So it gives a right to every individual of their conscience, free profession, practice and propagation of religion. However, this article does not give right for forceful conversion. So this article does not talk about forceful conversion. Individual have right to conscience, the free profession, practice and propagation of religion, but not forceful conversion. However, this Article 25 is subject to public order, morality and health, and the other provision of part 3, other fundamental rights. So this is the basic information that under Article 25, individual have right to freedom of religion. That is important. However, it does not include forceful conversion, and this right is subject to public order, morality, health, and other fundamental rights that are there in part 3 of the Constitution. So this is the basic information related to this topic. Earlier, the same type of bill has been passed in UP, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh. So these are some of the states. Now the second article is Karnataka announces no tax hike in budget. So this is not important. What is important is Meghdatu project. What is this project? So Meghdatu project, in which state? Karnataka. Approved by state government in 2017 in Ramanagaram district. Across which river? This will be built on Kaveri River. So that is important. That is state and river. These are two important facts. However, the primary objective is to supply drinking water to Bangalore and recharge groundwater. The primary objective is supply drinking water and recharge groundwater. These are the two objectives of this Mekedatu project. The constructed dam on Kaveri River, so we have discussed, it will be constructed on Kaveri River. However, the Tamil Nadu argued that it will considerably affect the natural flow of river and will severely affect the irrigation in Tamil Nadu. So, for example, the river passes through this, and this is Karnataka and this is Tamil Nadu. Karnataka says that because Karnataka is building a dam on Kaveri River for its use. However, this will affect the natural flow. That is, this will affect the natural flow on river, and therefore it will affect the irrigation in Tamil Nadu. So this is the basic information about Mekedatu. You have to remember where this Mekedatu project is, what is the purpose, which district, and which river. So these are the important points that are related to this topic. Now, article number 3, that is capital verdict. So as I told you, in 2014, Andhra Pradesh was divided into Andhra Pradesh, current Andhra Pradesh, and Telangana. Telangana is Andhra Pradesh capital was decided as Amravati, Telangana as Hyderabad. However, in 2014, the Amravati region was chosen as the site of the capital of Andhra Pradesh, the residuary state left after the creation of Telangana. But work was stopped after the present regime took over. However, it was decided that Amravati will be capital, but work was stopped. So instead, what Chief Minister did, Jagan Mohan Reddy did, mooted the idea of decentralized development, by which he meant the state will have Amravati as legis. So now what he's saying, that instead of having Amravati as a one capital, he is planning three capital. One capital will be Amravati, other will be Vishakhapatnam, and third will be Kurnool. Amravati will be legislative capital, Vishakhapatnam will be executive, and Kurnool will be justice, the capital for matlab justice, or you can say high court. So these are the judiciary, you can say judiciary. So these are the three capital that were mooted by Andhra Pradesh government. And what is the objective? It that decentralized development. For example, if this is a city A, and all these three are like placed in this city, and this city will be developed a lot. However, if we take different important organization of government and make them located in different cities, then this city will also be developed, this city will be also developed, this city. So for example, let's take this triangle, and instead of having all the capital at this point, if we having one capital here, one organization here, one organization here, the overall all-round development of the state will take the place. So this is what he said, decentralized development. So that was the idea mooted by Andhra Pradesh government. So now, in his turn, removed to three capital idea of present regime, a full bench of state high court. So what state high court has said, Andhra Pradesh high court has said, that it cannot abandon the project to develop Amravati. So it said that the government cannot abandon the project to develop Amravati as the capital city after over 33,000 acre land had been taken up by farmers and 15 crores sunk in over development. So now a state high court has said, so this much acre of land has been given up by farmer, taken by government, and already 15,000 crore rupees have been spent on development expenditure. So now government cannot do that. Government has to develop Amravati as a capital of Andhra Pradesh. So this is what High Court has said. However, High Court said it projected as a measure to decentralize government and take the fruit. So this was the idea of Andhra Pradesh government, that when development will be, the capitals will be all three places, then the development will be in all area of the state, and therefore it will take the fruit of the, therefore the fruit of development will be given, will be available in all parts of the state. So that was the objective. So what is important about this article is that the welcome feature of the verdict of the High Court, it has invoked the doctrines of constitutional trust and promissory estoppel to prevent a regime from going back to its promises on to citizens. So this High Court verdict has given this like the important feature at that it prevented a regime, that is, it prevented a regime from going back to its promises. So now, because Amravati was promised, now the government is saying no, we will not develop that as a only capital. So the High Court has prevented doing that from by state government, and this is known as promissory estoppel, that like is going, preventing going away from preventing going back from a promise made to the cities. So this is the important, this is the important point of this verdict. So we have discussed about three capitals that there will be. This was proposed: Amravati, Vishakhapatnam, Kurnool. This is legislative, this is executive, this is judiciary capital. However, in 2014, only one capital, that is Amravati, was chosen to be capital of Andhra Pradesh. So that is all important under this article. Now the another article: India abstains from vote to probe actions for Russia. So the Modi government, or you can say a government of India, has decided to abstain from three votes at UNSC. So UNSC, there were three votings done, India abstained, and then two in UN General Assembly, India abstained, two in United Nations Human Rights Council, India abstained, and then at one at International Atomic Energy Agency also. So these are the, at these are the situation in which India abstained from voting. India did not vote, India abstained from voting. So what is important here is that we have discussed about UNSC, we have discussed about UNGA. What is important here is IAEA, International Atomic Energy Agency. So the article says International Atomic Energy vote was particularly significant as it related to safety of four nuclear power stations and a number of nuclear waste sites, including Chernobyl, the Russian seize control. So the article says this voting in International Atomic Energy is much more important because it is related to four nuclear power plant and the nuclear waste site. Because if there is a nuclear explosion, or you can say a spread of nuclear radiation, then it will affect a large number of area, it will affect a large number of people, and it will also affect larger area. So that is why the voting was important in International Atomic Energy Agency. However, India abstained in that. So now we'll discuss about International Atomic Energy Agency. However, its headquarters, first thing is headquarters is in Vienna. So first thing, it was set up in 1957. Set up as World's Atom for Peace Organization. It was initially known as, or you can say, set up as World's Atoms for Peace Organization. So this was the initial. Now, International Atomic Energy, 1957. Later, it became an agency of UN. Later, it became an agency of UN. But you have to remember, it is not a principal, not a principal organ. Principal organ. It is mere an agency of United Nations. What is the objective? The objective is to promote the safe, secure, and peaceful use of nuclear technology. Objective: safe, secure, and peaceful use of nuclear technology. So this is the objective. Seeks to promote the peaceful use of nuclear energy, inhibit its use for any military purpose. Seeks to promote peaceful use, and prohibits or inhibits use of nuclear for military purposes or nuclear weapon. So this is the basic information related to International Atomic Energy Agency. So this is, you have to remember that this can come directly, and like a question can come directly on, like an article question can come directly on UN, NATO, or UNSC, or International Atomic Energy Agency, UNGA. So you just have to remember all the basic information related to these topics. Now the last article is Russia seizes Europe's largest nuclear power plant. So fears of potential nuclear. So now Russia has seized this, and there is a bombarding also. There is a fear of potential nuclear disaster at Zaporizhia plant. So you have to remember Europe's largest power plant, nuclear plant, which is this. This is Zaporizhia. So this is Europe's largest nuclear power plant. Has spread alarms across. Now it has captured by Russia, and bombarding also took place, and there was a fire. So it led to the fear in the European and European countries and across the world also. This nuclear power plant provides more than 1/5 of total electricity generated. So more than one fifth of Ukraine's electricity is provided by this nuclear power plant. So now we have discussed this. Now what Russia is demanding from Ukraine. So what Russia is demanding. So first thing it says that it insisted that Moscow's demand. So Mr. Putin told German Chancellor that Ukraine must agree to doom. First, Ukraine must demilitarize. Second, accept Moscow's sovereignty over Crimea. And third, surrender territory to Russian-backed rebel in, we have discussed which region, Donbas region, where the two rebel groups are Donetsk and Luhansk. So these are the three demands. So, and Russia, you annex Crimean Peninsula, it belongs to Ukraine, and it annexed
Crimean Peninsula in 2014. So this you have to remember, following the ouster of the country's former Moscow friendly leaders and casted support behind the rebels. So that is not important. What is important, Russia annexed Crimean Peninsula in 2014. And what are the Russia's demand now? First, that it must Ukraine must demilitarize, accept Russia's sovereignty over Crimea and surrender territory to Russia-backed rebel in Donbas region. And the rebel groups are Donetsk and Luhansk. Now we'll discuss five important questions related to today's topic. Question number one, International Atomic Energy Agency was established in which year? Option on 1949, 1955, 1957, 2002. The correct option is 1957. UNSC has how many non-permanent members? So we have discussed about UNSC many times. So now the question is non-permanent. It's asking for non-permanent member. Options 5, 10, 15, D. So the correct option is 10. So UNSC has permanent, non-permanent. Permanent numbers are 5, non-permanent number 10, selected for a period of 2 years. So India has been selected for eighth time. So this is you have to remember. P5, they are also known as P5. We have discussed many times. Again, we'll discuss USA, UK, France, China, Russia. Question number 3, Meghdatu project is planned on which river? So Meghdatu project in which river? Your options are Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari, none of the above. Correct option is Kaveri. Next question is, headquarter of International Atomic Energy Agency is located in which of the following? Your options are Vienna, New York, Washington, D.C., none of the above. Correct option is Vienna. Question number 5, Crimean Peninsula was annexed by Russia in which year? Your options are 2014, 2013, 2012, sorry, option A 2012, 2013, 2014, none of the above. The correct option is 2014. So that's all for this session. Stay logical with Vidikya, your best pal in CLAT preps.